الله الرحمن الرحيم. There are no words that I have in my vocabulary that can describe the feeling that I'm very sure that you are feeling right now. Awe is one of them. Anticipation, excitement, just a few words that can perhaps try and explain or try to encapsulate what you are feeling, because your Shaykh al-Kalam and Shaykh Muhammad Hisham al-Habbali is here. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve him. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve his influence upon us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continue to allow the nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to flow through his heart into our hearts, inshaAllah. There is no need for me to introduce him to the stage with the explanation you find on YouTube or the explanation you find on Wikipedia or whatever. All of you are well aware of this, otherwise you would not have been here. But what I will do is I will invite him to the stage, inshaAllah, with the rest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Which means, surely the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have nothing to fear and nor shall they grieve. This is the maqam. This is the stature and position that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to those people who leave their homes for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa salam. Verily, Shaykh Muhammad Hisham al-Kabbani is one of those great beings in the 21st century who from a very young age did justuju, did juhud, did struggle in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why in his age right now, he has been given the maqam of wali, subhanallah. Say subhanallah. People say, oh, there is a thing, wali, if a person disregards one person to be a wali, to be a saint of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, khalas. Fine, but if you disregard the concept of awliya, you are a munkar of the Quran, you are a disbeliever of the Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, ala inna awliya Allah, they are friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what a beautiful friendship, what a beautiful friendship between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the man and the human being. The human being who chants the name of Allah, who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa salam that is hidden deep within our hearts, who have unveiled the secret of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those people are the awliya ikram. And verily we have that person, one of those very amazing people before us, Shaykh Muhammad Hisham al-Kabbani. Like I said, I don't have enough words, nor do I have enough eloquence in my tongue. I'm a humble person in this sense, that I can introduce him to the stage. And you can see that emotions are running high already, but controlling our emotions is becoming difficult. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on these very words, allow us to take and seek all the barakah, the bounties and blessings and fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah alayhi salatu wa salam with the words of our Shaykh Muhammad Hisham al-Kabbani. Madda zilluhu al-Ali wa damat barakatuhum al-Qudsiya wal-Aliya. I will now introduce him to the stage, but before, let's do a nara like we do. Nara takbir.
Allahu Akbar!
Louder inshaAllah. Nara takbir.
Allahu Akbar!
Nara risalat.
Ya Rasulullah!
Nara hadri.
Ya Ali!
Hadri.
Salam. No, no, you keep it. I'll put it there.
Okay.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I know the time is running short, and I'm sorry I was late due to some emergencies and traffic. So let us begin as soon as possible by saying, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillahi ar-rahman ar-rahim. Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! Kabira!
وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا.
يا سيدي يا رسول الله يا رحمة للعالمين، انظرنا بنظرك يا حبيب الله، يا أبا البتول، يا أبا فاطمة الزهرة، ويا جد الحسن والحسين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي جعلنا من أحباب المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام، وشرفنا أن نكون من أمته، وجعلنا من أحبابه، وغفر لنا ما تقدم من ذنبنا وما تأخر بحرمة حبيبه المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. O Muslim brothers and sisters, we have to know that we are only helpless human beings. The one that is energizing us, the one that he is giving us power, the one who is charging our hearts, the one who Allah has sent rahmatan lil alamin, is that one, Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu wa salam. Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu wa salam خاطبه رب العزة بقوله إنا فتحنا لك فتحا مبينا ليغفر لك الله ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر. الله سبحانه وتعالى has told his prophet سيدنا محمد عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا. We have opened for you, Ya Muhammad, an opening that is can everyone can see. There is no way to people not to understand. When Allah says, we have opened for you a great opening, means there is no limit. There is no limit or limitation for what Allah has showed His Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What He showed him by that opening, He did not show anyone, not even His angels. And since when that opening has opened? Since when Allah opened that? Al-Quran, the Holy Quran, is not created. One of the most belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah that the Holy Quran is not created. The Holy Quran is Allah's ancient words. Kalamuhu al-Qadimi, His words that like all His beautiful names and attributes are His manifestations describing Him. Also the Holy Quran is part of that, is part of these holy names that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described Himself by Himself. That's why when He said Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi, He is praising Himself by Himself to Himself by saying Subhani, ma azama sha'ni, Subhanallah, what Allah, I am the great one, I am the grateful, I am the king of kings, I am the whatever you can imagine in your mind, I am above that. He says in Holy Quran, which was with the Holy Quran was His words before angels has been created, He said, Ya Muhammad, I opened for you a big opening. But it was revealed when Prophet was on earth to us.
But it was revealed to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when Prophet was a light of Allah's light. When he said, قَبَتُ كَبَّةً مِّن نُورِي قُلْتُ لَهَا كُونِ مُحَمَّدٍ. I took one hand of my light. الله نور السماوات والأرض. From that light, I took one hand, one power, and I said, be Muhammad, and it was Muhammad. So he said, before anyone is created, before the pen is created, before heavens are created, because all these are creation, they praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Holy Quran is his words, cannot be created. From that time he is talking to his beloved one Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom he created from his light, where he says, Ar-Rahman allama al-Quran khalaqa al-insan. That Ar-Rahman has taught Quran, then he created creation. So to whom he taught Quran? To Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He taught him when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was light. When from that light Allah created everything. So Allah is saying to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you must be happy because you are his ummah. You are his nation. He said, Ya Muhammad, I have opened for you a big opening. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. We have given you, kawthar means a lot. No way to describe that lot. No one can describe that too many things that Allah has given to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With all that, he said, and we are not going to explain, go into that deep, because it's very deep. Then people come and say, what you are talking, oh, it's too much. We say, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah is saying to him, إِنَّ فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا. We have opened for you a big opening. Can anyone decrease that opening? Can anyone close that opening? Can this battle can close that opening? No way! Battle cannot close Haqq. And Haqq are you. You are on Haqq. You are Allah's servant. You are Prophet's Ummah. You are on Haqq. No one close that Haqq. No one close, cannot close Islam. Because Islam is Haqq. He said to his Prophet, we have opened for you a big opening. For Allah to forgive you, Ya Muhammad. لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ دَنْبِكَ. To forgive us, to forgive you from your sin that before a prophet has sinned. Prophet does he have sin? So why Allah is saying then I have to I'm forgiving you from your sin, what is before and after? Because Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is Allah, from Allah's light. There is no, you cannot question that light. Allahu nuru samawati wal ard. Allah is the light of heavens and earth. Mathalu nurihi kamishkat. The example of his nur is like a bundle of many stars. Mathalu nurihi kamishkatin fiha misbah. The example of his nur is too many beautiful attributes of that nur. That nur alone consists of infinite number of colors, means of manifestations, that Allah made it as a bundle to Muhammad and he put inside the misbah Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalus salatu wassalam. مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح. المصباح في زجاجة. That lamp is in a glass. الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري. Means Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is that planet. Durri means from pearls. That planet by itself, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, is the planet, is the universe. It's not that one who is in Medina only, but his power is everywhere. Because Allah said, لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. Means Allah will forgive you from your sin before and your sin after. What kind of sin then? It's not the sin that Prophet has done. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is worried for his ummah, Ya Rabbi, forgive them. Allah wants to tell him, Ya Muhammad, you are the one that loading on your shoulder the sins of your ummah. I am forgiving your ummah from before and from after. Don't be sad. I am forgiving them because you are worried about your ummah. Since I created you as light and you are saying to me, my ummah, I am forgiving them. I am sending them to paradise. That's why he said, who came before you? Sins means this, whatever they have done of sins before you, I am forgiving them for your sake. And those who are coming after you, I am forgiving them for your sin, for your sake. لِيَغْفِرَ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. أي ما تقدم من ذنوب العباد وما تأخر من ذنوب العباد. ليس لك يا محمد فيها أي شيء, ولكن من أجلك غفر الله للأمة جميعا من أولها إلى آخرها. For your sake, Allah create, Allah forgave everyone from before, everyone from after, because of you, Ya Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And then Allah said, are you happy? We did something that you like. Are you happy? أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. Didn't we made your heart to be happy? We have expanded your chest, Ya Muhammad. When someone is happy, he can feel, he is laughing. And when he's laughing, his chest is opening up more and more and more and more until his tears come from his eyes. So, Ya Muhammad, I am making you to be happy. Smile and laugh. أَلَمْ أَنَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. We did not expand your chest to be happy. وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ. And we have taken away all the burden that on yourself. And what burden Prophet has? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't have any burden because he doesn't carry any sin. But the burden of the ummah. وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ. أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهْرَكَ. We didn't take all this burden by forgiving them what is before you and what is after you. And we took that burden away from you and raised you high. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. We made your remembrance not on walls like today. We see only on some walls in masajid Allah. We don't see the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We say, why you don't see the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Muhammad does not exist. They say shirk. What shirk? Allah is not making shirk then. When he say, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ, we have raised your name high up, that everyone, not only on walls, but everyone is ordered from angels. angel and jinn and universe and human beings to mention your name, O Muhammad, or they don't go to paradise. You cannot say La ilaha illallah without Muhammad or Rasulullah. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. We have made on every tongue of human beings your name to be mentioned. On every tongue of angels, if they have tongue, we don't know what kind of creation Allah created them. But we have to explain. Because they are ordered to make tasbih. Are not they ordered to make salawat on you, Ya Muhammad? I made them to make salawat on you by saying, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. I made all angels that I created and I'm creating and I will create, they are under my order to make salawat on you in every moment, Ya Rasulallah, Ya Habiballah. Then what is our salawat then? Compared to salawat of angels. Our salawat, we ask and we request and we beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the sake of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to accept our salawat. Because our salawat is so much blended with all our bad amal. We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to clean it, to make it like salawat of angels. When angels are making salawat, there is no ego there. There is no arrogance there. Today, if someone his voice is beautiful, he think himself that or herself that they are the best not people, or they are the best of Qasida people, and they put for them big chairs to sit, like they put for me a big chair, I feel shy to sit on it. Put big chair for them to sit because they are praising Prophet, Alhamdulillah, they deserve a chair, they deserve, but they must be humble. Because might be yours, not is not accepted even. Because if it is mixed with your ego, it's not accepted. Someone who is giving a talk, an advice, must not see himself. If he sees himself, then his talk is not going to reach anyone's heart. He must see himself lower than everyone in the audience. To humble, humiliate himself. In order to say, Ya Rabbi, I am helpless, you help me. Don't let me to be arrogant. Your Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, which is a very big, we say in French, manchette, banner. He said, one big banner there. إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. He said, I have been sent. I, Muhammad, خاتم الرسل, the beloved one to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I have been sent to perfect the human being character, the human nature character, their behaviors to each other, their discipline to each other. For that Allah has sent me. So Islam is character and behaviors. Because Allah said, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Religion for Allah is Islam, and Prophet says, I have been sent to perfect your character, mean Islam equals character and behavior, discipline. And look at our discipline today. Are we perfect in our behaviors and discipline? Is there people cursing each other or not. Families are divorcing wife and husbands because they have no characters, no behavior toward each other, no love toward each other. And Prophet ﷺ saying, I have been sent to perfect your character because Allah perfected my character. أدبني ربي فأحسن تأديبي. He said, Allah perfected my character, means there is no more perfection above perfection of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, I am coming from that background, I am coming from that perfection, I have been sent to perfect you, to perfect the ummah. And what kind of perfection? Perfection is to accept everyone else. Don't try to think what is the good manner and the behaviors. The good manners and the good behaviors can be summarized in very short words. To be humble. When you are humble, you are not angry. When you are humble, you are not jealous. When you are humble, you are not arrogant. When you are humble, you are not spying on people. When you are humble, you are not making conspiracies. When you are humble, you don't fight with others. When you are humble, you don't curse each other. When you are humble, you can sit near each other. Brother and brother, they don't sit near each other. They are fighting. Father and husband and wives, they fight with each other. Sister and sister fighting with each other. Communities are fighting with each other. A prophet Allah has sent in order to perfect our characters. That's why Allah said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Ya Muhammad, Allah is telling Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because Allah made him like that. Allah created him like that. He said, Ya Muhammad, do you know yourself? I am praising you. You are so humble. You are not offering to say anything in my presence. But Ya Muhammad, you must know that you are of the best character. You are the best one to me. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah is saying to him, Allah is speaking to him, Allah is talking to him, Allah is addressing him. That's why they said, many Muslim of Ahl Sunnah scholars, that Sayyidina Muhammad, between them Imam Nawawi, that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the night of Mi'raj, he saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the eyes of his head. He's saying to him, Ya Muhammad, you are of the best character. I fixed that character. I perfected that character. There is no higher than that. According to my greatness, I dressed you, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O Muslim brothers and sisters, this speech and the other speeches and every night has been done today, Allah will reward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you what ma la aynun ra'at wa la udhunun sami'at wa la khatara ala qalbi bashar, what an eye cannot see, what an ear cannot hear, what you cannot imagine, may Allah give you. May Allah bless you and bless you with the best of iman and ihsan. This is a meeting on the level of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a meeting that we have to take away from our hearts and take with us to our homes. Today, every meeting you must have to note something that you learned. Today, let us take that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah said to him, أَدَّبَنِي رَبِّي. He said, أَدَّبَنِي رَبِّي فَأَحْسَنَ تَأْدِيبِي. Allah perfected my manners. And he said, I have been sent to you to perfect your manners. And Allah has perfected me. So I am the humble one. I am the most humble in creation. I am the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this creation for me, and I am still humble. If between us become a minister, he will think himself he went to the roof. He went to paradise. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has made him the head of universe, the messenger of all creations, and he was humble. So take with you today, humbleness is the key for paradise. Humbleness is the key for the heart of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't think that Prophet is not looking at us. Whenever we call Ya Sayyidi Ya Rasulullah, he will say Labbaik Ya Ummati. When we say Ya Rabbi Ya Allah, Allah will say Labbaik Ya Abdi, I will answer you. Sayyidina Muhammad is ordered to answer us. Whenever we send salam to him, Allah send his soul back to him to send salam to us. Say salawat, say Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim tasliman kathira. Rabbi ighfir warham wa tajawaz amma ta'lam innaka ta'lam ما لا نعلم إنك أنت الله العزيز الغفار. May Allah forgive us. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless us. May Allah make everyone at the threshold of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam standing. Do you think that if Allah gave you the permission to be in the presence of Prophet, do you think that you will be in rows or you will be in line or no line and no rows? There will be lines and rows, there will be no lines and rows. Everyone will be standing and thinking as if he is standing with Prophet. He will see Prophet in front of him. Because when you do salawat on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if 1 million people around the earth is doing salawat, Sayyidina Muhammad is answering them in the same time with 1 million salawat. Means he will be 1 million of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in front of everyone as a vision. That's why when you go to Madinatul Munawwara visiting Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, don't think that he is not present with you. He is present with everyone. But open your eyes, open your hearts, and opening the eyes and hearts is be humble. May Allah makes us humble. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us to leave narcotics and to leave all this kind of marijuanas and I don't know what and what and what, because you are not going to get it with you to the grave. You are going to leave it here and you are going without it to the grave. If you be able to take it away from your dunya, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you as youth in the akhirah for more and more barakah. Every day is coming to me men and husbands and mothers crying that their children are using marijuana and using all kind of poisonous elements that they are drinking and they are drinking and they are drinking. We are on haq, and haq doesn't like that. Haq justice doesn't like that. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, I have been sent to perfect your character. That is not a good character for the youth to use all these kind of drugs. Stand up and say, Ya Rabbi, forgive us. Stand up by your room and say, Ya Rabbi, forgive us. We don't want to take it anymore. We don't want to carry drugs anymore. We want your love and the love of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah accept. May Allah forgive. We say, Ya Rabbi, we did our best. It's from you, Hidayah. ولا تهدي من أحببت إن الله يهدي من يشاء. الهداية منك يا الله. الهداية اهدنا يا ربي يا الله. اهدهم يا ربي يا الله إلى الطريق المستقيم. اهدهم يا ربي يا الله لأن يكونوا من عبادك الصالحين. من عبادك المخلصين. من عبادك المخلصين. لك يا الله. بحبيبك يا الله. من أمة جميعا يا يا الله يا الله يا الله. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. If we will stay standing till day of judgment for the love of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we will not be able even to give his own right. He is more than that, he deserves more than that. If the whole universe is standing and making salawat, still Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is required for his own right to do more and more from us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we say, Ya Rabbi, we are weak servants. We cannot do except this what we have able to do. The rest on you and on your prophet. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bi hurmatil fatiha. I think Maghrib is on. If you want to pray Maghrib on time,
we don't got enough space here for the.
No, so he can go and they pray. He can have another 10 minutes, is no problem.
Unfortunately, we haven't enough space for all of you to perform your Maghrib prayer here. After the dua of Sheikh, you can go closest mosque is the Al-Fadi Islamic Center. You can perform your namaz there, Maghrib namaz, or whatever you like, inshallah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ربنا تقبل منا واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واهدنا إلى الحق وإلى طريق المستقيم وانصرنا على القوم المفسدين وانصر سلطاننا سلطان المسلمين. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وعافنا وعاف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون سلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة. if the shortest distance to the mosque is not far, we are for such reasons sometimes Islam is yassiru wala tu'assiru. Make it easy, don't make it difficult. One came to Prophet said, Ya Rasulullah, too much discipline, too much conditions. Give me something easy. He said, keep your tongue wet with zikrullah. So for those who think themselves they will lose their maghrib, they can keep sitting and pray sitting. And then when you go home, you repeat it. But at least you prayed it on time. Because when you are on an airplane or a car and you have a traffic and then the maghrib is going to pass, what you do? You let it pass or you sit praying sitting. Praying sitting or not? So if you like, you pray sitting. At least if you reach the masjid quickly, then you repeat it. If you didn't reach, then you are already done your obligation. You repeat it later at home. Now Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah might say to me, oh, from where you gave this fatwa?
I would like to say thank you all of you who came here and who you participated in this program. May Allah give you eternal reward.